under $5, DIY ponytail. Also, I am gonna be showing you guys clips of me getting my hair cut by my boyfriend. Those will be at the end, so stay till the end of the video. Okay, so we're gonna jump right into the tutorial. And you only need two things to make this ponytail. I have here the hair that you'll need for the ponytail, and it's the, I got mine from $1.99, but they range from $1 to $1.99 at the beauty supply store. This is Kinkawan hair, jumbo braiding hair. One pack is enough, and a hair tie. So you do not want to have a ponytail holder that has the metal or the glue holding it together, because you want something durable that you'll be able to stretch and stretch and stretch with this ponytail. Now, after you see the technique, I feel like you'll be able to decide whether or not you can use a different type of texture hair. I think you can, except you'll need something that's gonna be long. So straight hair is probably the easiest hair to use to make this ponytail. But I say experiment. If you have old tracks, old wigs at home, you should experiment and see what you come up with. I'm sure most of you have bought this pack of hair before. It's the most generic, easy to find hair. Sometimes they even sell it in like dollar stores, like Dollar General as well. If you've dealt with this hair before, you know that it kind of frizzes and tangles easy, so you wanna be very gentle and careful when you're separating the hair. You don't wanna be too rough with it, because it'll create tangles that you can't comb through, and that is a disaster, trust me. You separate your first section of hair. It should look like this. It should be about this big, or this thick, I guess I should say. So you want a loop like this so that you can wrap it. I hope you guys can see this. Wrap this around the ponytail holder. So now you should have a loop of hair going through the ponytail holder just like this. So much harder to like film this than just do it myself. Then you want to put your fingers through so that you can grab the hair and slide it through. Just like that. Then you're gonna pull it really tight around your ponytail holder. So now you have your first piece of hair. And the reason I picked like that thickness of hair is because it ends up doubling at the bottom, so you get it thicker. You're just gonna repeat that process with the rest of the hair. Once you get it on there, you should be able to slide it. You just hold it tight and keep pulling the hair until it meets up with the other one that you did. And then there you go. But if you do not follow me on Instagram, then you missed my photos that I took with this ponytail that I made. I went to a photo shoot event here in Oklahoma City at Studio 12. And it was very, very cool. It was like a networking event where photographers and, you know, people who model and all of that, they got together to see what kind of cool images they could create using the studio. I wanted something really like glamorous, because I knew I wanted some nice pictures if I took them. I went with the intention to shoot, but I ended up getting in front of the camera anyway, because I like being in front of the camera. Yeah, I think I learned that I may like directing and modeling more than I like shooting, because I'm not that good with the camera just yet. So I'm sure you guys get the gist, but one more time for those of you if you do not understand. I'm gonna loop this hair through the hair tie like this. Then carefully, so you don't create too much frizz, put your fingers through and pull the hair through it. By doing that, now you've created a loop on top of the ponytail. Then now I'm just sliding it down to meet up with the others that I've put on. And all the flyaway hairs, before you tighten it really, really tight, just pull them out. If they're not with the rest, just pull them out. That's why it's very important to have one of these types of ponytail holders, because no matter how far you stretch it, it's never gonna break. I was thinking also about doing a Q&A. I only have 325 subscribers at the moment, but I do want to have a video up, you know, that's explaining a little bit about myself so that people know who I am, know who they're watching, who they're taking advice from and tutorials from, you know. So whoever's watching, if you would like to, if you want to ask me questions about anything, I mean about maybe where I'm from, which I'm from Brooklyn, New York. You guys didn't know that I am. And my parents are from the Caribbean, so I grew up eating lots of Caribbean food and making fun of both my parents' accents. It's my favorite thing to do. So yeah, if you guys have any questions, you know, if you're curious about anything, I would love to answer them. Simple things like I'm sure my age, 24, all that basic stuff. I feel like, of course you guys would want to know that. Maybe I'll look on YouTube and find some other Q&As and steal some questions if I don't get enough, but I just wanted to put it out there. So if anyone watching has questions, they should ask them in this video. This is my last piece of hair. In the end, you see you end up with a really nice, like, full ponytail. I want to make sure you pull these hairs really tight. See, this one's already getting loose. So the last thing you want to do before you put your ponytail on, which I am going to show you how to do, is clip the ends. I don't want it to be too even. I want it to look like a realistic ponytail, and no one's ponytail is, like, really cut even like that. So I'm just gonna trim these extra long hairs. You guys should definitely follow me on Instagram so that you can see all of my hairstyles and stuff when I do it first. And also you can see if there's anything you want me to film. Like this cut crease look. This is my very first cut crease. Very first one. I'm sure you guys watched my very first makeup tutorial where I told you that I don't really do eyeshadow and stuff like that, so I really stepped out of my comfort zone. I feel like it could be better, and obviously I've seen some really amazing cut creases, so you know, I got a lot of work to do, but I'm kind of proud of myself for just, you know, being brave and stepping out there. So I hope you guys think it's cute. First things first, I'm gonna put my hair in a ponytail. I'm gonna use my Back to Eden Aloe Rose Leave-In all over my hair. I'm going to take some of my Back to Eden Organics Whipped Hair and Body Oil. You guys saw me use this in my last video, my Bright Out Routine, and if you haven't seen it, you should go watch it. The hardest thing about filming with my camera is that I absolutely cannot see myself right now. So I don't know how crazy or not crazy I look right now. I'm just letting y'all have it raw, unedited. I'm going to take my Prima Nature Perfect Edges Edge Control. Take your hair tie, and you want to make this ponytail as tight as you possibly can. So what you want to do here is you want to, okay, before I attach the ponytail, I do recommend blow drying your hair. You don't have to, you can stretch your hair, but my hair is a little bit more of a triangular shape, you see, so it would be more beneficial to me if I blow dried my hair before. I'm gonna try to make it as easy as I can on camera. Cause you know when you're by yourself, I can flip head over, I can get down in there to do what I gotta do. So, easiest thing to do is to just go ahead and pull your hair through, just like this. And you want the ponytail, cause when you flip it over, you want the ponytail to be on top of your hair, so. Simply drop your hair. Now you want to kind of line up this ponytail and pull it tight with your hair here in the front. like this. And then you want to pretend that it's all your hair and put your hair in a ponytail. So now you got the ponytail holder, just pull it all the way through. I have my fake ponytail wrapped around my real hair. Separating my hair in half, and I'm going to twist this side. Take this, and I'm just gonna wrap it around the ponytail. I did not expect for this to be this difficult on camera, to tell you the truth. Now you just want to pin it very tightly, because you do not want it to slip. That is a no-no. You don't want it to slip, for real. So I had to finish twisting my hair off camera, because I have my little mirror here off to the side, but I need to like really see what I was doing. This is the ponytail, and that's my hair that I twisted around and I pinned in the back. Now we're gonna go in and slick all these flyaways down with our edge control. You just want to kind of position your ponytail to hide, you know, whatever part of the base you don't want to see. So I kind of want mine to go like this. Last thing you want to do is attack the baby hairs. Like I said, I think it would be smarter if you blow dried your hair first so that you could blend your actual hair in it, or like I did, you can twist up all of your hair around the base of the ponytail. My ends are really, really bad. I don't even want to go into 2017 with hair like this. So there's only one person that I trust to cut my hair besides myself. It's either I attempt to cut all of this or I trust him to do it. So I figured, why not bring you guys here with me so that you can see him cut my hair.
Give us a thumbs up if you like Tisha's new look. Styles by Ju.
What do I look like? I know I look crazy.
Quick disclaimer, my boyfriend is a licensed barber, which is why I trust him to cut my hair. I do not recommend anyone just cutting their hair spur of the moment like this. I also left all of our social media information in the description bar below. Thank you guys for watching.